expires, the tickets will be reduced tremendously. You will find the tires company specialized in certain type of tires per plant, not the way it is done today. This would be part of the tendency that you would see. You see this in other industries as well, of trying to specialize in a product. And the tire, a plant that would be making passenger tires would be making a certain passenger tires. I must tell you that one of the best tires that the plant that I've ever seen in my life is Alexandria Tires in Ichi, which is really old and which has 5 truck tire sizes and 4 four lines. The plant is busy 7 days a week, 24 hours, supplies all of the Middle East, high quality tires, and I've been told by Pirelli people it's the most profitable plant that Pirelli has. Outsourcing will become the name of the game. Plants will outsource many, many things that they don't outsource today. Although, not too many years ago, if I would tell a plant manager that he needs to outsource his textiles and stop buying yarns and dipping them and weaving them, he would look at me like I'm crazy. Today, I think there are no more plants that are doing it. Perhaps one of these stewards that I know and is already offered the equipment for sale, and I think there's one in India. But nobody produces their own yarns or textiles. So in a few years, there will be no compounding in a tire plant, because compounding is a separate production. It is it is dirty by nature. It requires a lot of other resources that a tire plant does not need. And many people, when I talk about it, they say, oh, Jacob, no. Compounding is an integral part of any tire plant and so on. I know several very successful tire plants today who have no compounding, and I know that even the large companies, very quietly, like Goodyear, they centralize the production of compounding elsewhere rather than do it in their own plant. And we'll talk about later how a plant would look, and you'll see that it will be a lot smaller, a lot cleaner, without space. A very important factor. Space is not available anymore. In most countries, land becomes very expensive and scarce. You don't want a tire company very far from its customers, so you're basically looking at expensive area. It will force tire companies to become smaller. The huge tire companies that still exist or that have existed in the past, this is a thing of the past. No one would have taken here a photo of a plant that we're working with in the United States. This plant is closed, by the way. One of the reasons was the size. This is the next Cooper plant. Geographical considerations. Today, the tire industry is one of the main providers to the shipping companies in the world. I mean, I don't think that there are many products that are being shipped and handled and so much money spent on this like the tire industry. This will stop. This will stop because tire companies would produce for the areas where they are and not to ship tires from China to UK or from India to Europe. There will always be some because of specialization, but it will be much reduced because it is illogical to ship air in containers or in other other means, and it will stop, and it will make, it will change the look of the target. The other factor is the change in tire construction. Tires will change. The definition of tire by many people who know them is, as I said before, is black and almost round. Who said that the tire has to be black? Who said that the tire needs to be round? Tires can have other shapes. And it is difficult to imagine, but that's what is eventually going to happen. I think the roundness will remain as long as mobility is a main factor, but it will be whatever. Okay, you will see. You see already the major companies are developing other tires which do not depend on air as the main factors that hold the tire together. This thing has not changed for generation. It's time that it changed. And Michelin and Bridgestone and Mitas are already very big. These are the examples that I give. I know of many more. Developing tires which will be different. You, for clarity and honesty purpose, I must say that the Leotrac is a tire that our company is developing. So I'm not objecting. But as Mika said to me, he said this tire could only be designed by someone who does not understand the tire industry at all. Doesn't understand tires. And that's exactly what happened. Two Israeli engineers that came to us, they gave us a design of a tire that the first reaction said, please go away. And it happened. A lot of changes to become the candidate tonight for the innovation of the year time at this thing. So I hope it will win. Our competitor is Bridgestone, it's another time. So, but basically what I'm saying is, the concept of this time is, just to give you an example, is that when you inflate this tire, the sidewalls do not have to deflect to the outside, they deflect to the inside. When you think of it, it looks crazy, but it is not, because what it happens is the air chamber is much smaller, the sidewall is much more protected, and the tire is by nature an unflat tire. Was not meant to be. It has become, and it can run without air or with very little air. It changes. Construction becomes oval. Oval tube is very important for agricultural tires, for military, for earth mover, and that's where it is going right now. But it will eventually be on other tires as well. And the same with Bridgestone and Michelin. I think that the Twill tire is a great invention, needs still to be worked on, but it will become later on a major product in the market. Okay, in summary, I feel that taking all this into account, what I just said, the tires company will be automated, will be different, will be smaller, and will adhere to strict environmental requirements. As I say here, it will be able to deliver products at a rate that will be suitable to its size and function. I also believe that the tire companies would pay more attention to what the market requires rather than the other way around. For many years, now I'm old enough to remember, tires were manufactured and then the market was asked to buy them. I think in France it's still the same. Okay, the future plant. The future plant will have no mill room. much smaller plant, a much cleaner plant. Can you imagine a tire plant that have no buyers for raw material? Just this department will disappear. It will have different laboratories, so the laboratories will be required to check what is being delivered. You would find that the mill which will disappear will bring with it to a tire company a different prospectus altogether in what has to be done with raw material and with components. I have seen that happen in some tire companies. I cannot mention name, but I want to assure you that this is a trend. This has been taken from a company, a Finnish company, Sinco, who is very active in they call it the dream factory, but it is really developing technology for automation of tire companies. They're doing a fantastic job. We don't know them personally so well, but we know well of their work. Material and compound testing facilities will increase, not decrease, because of the outsourcing. They may decrease if the tire company will be able to convince the supplier to do all the tests himself, and the tire company would be prepared to be assured of these tests that are done by someone else. I doubt it. Components preparation. Components preparation in a modern tire plant would be different. There would be a lot of equipment which will completely disappear. This includes tread extruders, this includes calenders, this includes, of course, all the mixing equipment, but in component preparation, you would find that the inner liner calendar would be a thing of the past in no time. Why? Because already a film has been developed. I think Sumitomo is one of the people who has been using it, and Exxon has come with a plastic film that replaced inner liner, does a much better job, much lighter, and I don't know why this development has not been done in the past, but it is. You will see this in all tire companies. At that moment, the huge extruder, the 10-inch extruder with the roller dies, will be a thing of the past. There was the inner liner calendars, the very expensive 4-5 million euros a piece would disappear, and you would find that every tire building machine has an additional small servicer where this plastic foam or foil is being applied. Same thing would happen with preparing belts. You would find stylistic type or VMI flex type, they call it, machines would replace the need for these huge lines that are today providing these components. Tire building is already, we don't need to look for the future so much because tire building today, a 25-second BMI or HF machine is not anymore the future, it's existing. It will be shorter when they don't have to apply the inner liner. It will be even shorter when some of the components will be prepared in advance with zero tolerance. Because one of the problems of the modern tire building machines is that they cannot really cope with materials which have too much tolerance in size and they stop. Then the whole line. So this will not be the case, and you will find a lot more tires are made on the machine. This happened to be a BMI machine, and 25 seconds is not a dream. I mentioned here the film. We'll go further. The one department which remained a little bit a problem for me to since the future is a human department, it is a bottleneck of every entire company, it is still the bottleneck and it will be in the future. I think that what would happen now is that new methods of queuing would be developed to reduce or to eliminate this bottleneck. I don't think we can eliminate it, but we can reduce it. And how can we reduce it? We can by having bladders that would not have to be replaced every 300 or 400 times, but after 10,000 times. And I know already people working on it. The release agents would be part of the compound. I know two bladder manufacturers who already offer on a test basis these bladders with the release agents already part of the compound, and you don't need to spray neither the mold nor the bladder. A big saving, not only in money, but in dirt, and it needs to clean, needs to change, etc. I have seen in the curing department, I've seen presses which are much more efficient than today's presses, working, there is the hot water system that the huge system will also disappear completely. There will be other means to create the pressure. I believe the pressure will be lower, not higher. I will be the temperature will be lower, not higher, because the modern materials can cope with curing, fast curing, at lower temperatures, lower pressures. This would make this department much more efficient. I also believe that, and I know people are looking at it, at curing in two stages. Curing the carcass and then curing the tread. Curing the carcass makes it unnecessary to use a segmented mold, which is very expensive and which is slow, which is very heavy. You need big, even for small tires, you need big machines in order to handle it. I have seen people using pre-cured tread on new tires in order to have faster produced tires, eliminating the necessary to cure the tread. Why? Because if you cure tread on a flat press, it is faster, you can apply a lot more pressure, and the quality, this is known from the retread industry, the quality of a retread is as good as a new tire. You don't have less mileage, you don't have any other problem with the thread. You have a problem with the adhesion of the thread to the carcass. But on new carcasses, this is, I have seen that those tests done. Again, I cannot say names because of confidentiality agreement that we have, but believe me that this is done. The result will be that if curing would be faster and simpler, that you would be able to increase the speed on the tire milling machines and have more tire milling machines without having to make tremendous changes in the in your construction. I'm showing here an example of being automatically fed to a press and produced. Testing would still remain a major issue. Remain a major issue because of the dependence on outsourcing, because of specialization, because of the increased demands. This would probably be the only department which will be increased a lot, decreased. And I'm talking about all testing, acceptance of raw materials to the finished products. The last one is storage and forwarding. Storage and forwarding will become fully automatic. It's already semi-automatic today. It will be completely automatic. You would find, and I'm mentioning here a Professor Tarik that is developing much easier, and the information that you would get would be available at all time. You would find that distribution of the tiles would be done automatically, automatic storage. Synco, I know, has done a lot of work with it, and other companies too. I can mention the name. I've been to Nokia recently, and I've seen a fantastic distribution of tiles and robotic pickup, which is, this is what is going to happen in the future. As I said, once electric cars will be the main car in the world, it will have a big effect on the tires itself. Again, the car companies will not let it become go too fast, but I think they cannot stop it any longer because batteries have been improved. Nobody likes better than to put a plug in his home to fill up the car and not go to a filling station. And I believe that you would see that this would have a very strong effect on the tire industry as well. I mentioned the Mitas tires that you would see tonight as an example, but I've already said what I wanted to say. There will be a separate discussion of this tire in another presentation, so I leave it. Thank you very much. A little bit about Thermal Engineering. Thermal Engineering is a company that does everything possible and that you can imagine regarding the tire and rubber industry, except buying and selling tires. We don't touch commercially tires because most of the tire companies in the world are either our customers or our suppliers, and we're very happy to be part of this industry. Thank you very much. Thanks to these people who supply me the information. Enjoy your lunch.
It seems to be that everybody's hungry already. So I'd like to thank you for this speech. Thank you for this interesting view on that. The food comes next in the direction. So I will go to this session right now. So I should remain, remind you just not forget to pick up your tickets for the gala dinner at the organizer's office. So enjoy your lunch. Thank you for.